everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It is me, Laurentia Monet, and today I will be showing y'all how I got this cute pink wig. It's just giving very much. So first, let's get into the hair details. This is a 613 wig from Yolissa Hair. It is 16 inches, 200 density, and a medium size cap. Of course, the link will be down below. As you can see, I will be water dyeing this wig. So of course, the first step is to do about 2 to 3 layers of got to be and blow drying it in between so that lace does not get stained, okay? So I kind of made this wig on the fly, so I forgot to show y'all the bottle, but I put it in the corner and I am using the Adore Cotton Candy, and we're just putting that in some hot water, and you want to make sure that it's actually hot. So I started off just trying to see how one bottle would look on the hair, and that was kind of too light for me. So depending if you want a real pastel cotton candy pink, one bottle might be fine for you, but I ended up using 2. I really could have gotten away with just using 1.5, but I just used 2. Now you all see that I like the shade of pink that I had here, so I am just submerging the wig into the water, and I'm just making sure to comb it through while it's in there because you don't want to have a whole bunch of patches of blonde, which I still ended up having, but you still just want to try to comb the color through before you just plop it in there so that it can sit. Now that I've combed that color all the way through, I finally submerged the wig and I set a timer on my phone for 5 minutes. And here I am coming back to check it in. Now I'm going to show y'all that I did still have a few blonde patches in the wig, and also I feel like it could have gotten a little darker. So what I did was I just made sure to really try to comb that color through and really get those blonde patches out so that the wig is fully pink and not pink with blonde streaks or blonde patches, you know. So after making sure that the blonde patches were going to be gone, I just combed it through again and I sat it in the water for another 5 minutes. And this was the result after that. You see it got a little darker. Those blonde patches are gone and it looks so good. Like, the color is so cute. After I go through and inspect it and make sure that there are no blonde patches, I'm rinsing out with cold water. Please make sure to rinse it out with cold water because that's really what is going to lock that hair color in. So after I rinse it with cold water, comb it through a little bit, I'm going to be sitting it in my silicone mix for about 20 minutes. And then I'm going to wash it out and then we're going to be ready to put it on. Okay, so I just recently made a detailed video about how I install my wigs. I'm using that same method, same ball cap method, doing the same 3 layers that I usually do. So if you want to see how I install my wigs in detail, be sure to check out that video. Okay, so side note, if you saw my last video where I was installing my wig, y'all saw I was struggling with my baby hairs, but I was practicing before I did this video, and now I know how to do my baby hairs. Like, I did it on the first try. I'm so proud of myself. Y'all should be proud of me, too. And another side note, so I know y'all see that white track that's in the back. Okay, I didn't leave it like that. I be thinking I have a 13x6 when I have a 13x4, so I be trying to do these deep parts, forgetting that I can't do this. So maybe I need to start investing in 13x6s, but don't worry, I wasn't outside like this. I fixed it, okay? Now we are done. Look at that color. Like, y'all, I was so scared to do this wig. I've had this wig and the Adore hair color for like 2 months because I was so scared to do this wig color, but it turned out really, really cute. Like, so cute. I got so many compliments. So please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope to see y'all in my next video. Bye.